the concept of derangements. Before I get into the mathematics involved, let us solve a bunch of basic questions around this concept. Please pause the video and try doing it yourself. Four letters, let's say A, B, C, and D, and four envelopes, let's call them A, B, C, and D, lowercase. All letters go into right envelopes. Of course, there's only one case. The answer here is one. Second question. Three letters go into right envelopes. Imagine, is that practically possible? If one letter goes into wrong envelope, let's say it goes into the envelope of B, then the letter B is also bound to go into some wrong envelope, A, C, or D, and therefore this case is not possible. The answer is zero here. Two letters go into right envelopes. How do we do this? First of all, we have to select two letters which go into the right envelopes. So out of these four letters A, B, C, and D, two can be selected in 4C2 ways, that is 6. And now whatever the two are left, one letter has one choice of envelope, the wrong choice, and the other letter also has only one choice, 1. So the answer is 6 into 1 into 1. So the answer here is 6. One letter goes into the right envelope. So once again, 4C1. One letter out of four that goes into the right envelope can be selected in 4C1 or four ways. And now imagine you have four letters A, B, C, and D, and one letter has been selected. Let's say A goes into the right envelope. Of course, it could be A, B, C, or D. That's why four cases. And now three are left. B has two choices, and then C and D would have one choice each. Okay, so total number of cases, 4 into 2 into 1 into 1, the answer is 8. And then no letter goes into right envelope. This is the case of perfect derangement. Doing this manually will be a bit complex, and therefore some mathematics is involved. This question is indirectly asking you the number of derangements for four objects. Let's understand this concept. Derangement is an arrangement of elements that leaves no element in its original or correct position. For example, in the last case here, no letter goes into right envelope, four elements, and none of the four go into the correct position. The total number of possible derangements for a set with n elements is, it's called Dn when there are n elements, and you look at this formula. See, the first two elements are basically adding up to 0. So you can very well just eliminate this, and then 1 upon 2 factorial. Now, if the number involved is odd, the sign becomes negative. If the number involved in the denominator is even, the sign becomes positive. And ultimately, the series ends with n factorial. And once again, if n is even, the sign would be positive, otherwise negative. And now, here is a grid for values. Imagine if there's only one object, it cannot be deranged. Therefore, zero ways of deranging one object. If there are two objects, imagine A, B, A, B. There's only one way of derangement, that they take each other's position. So only one way. D3 is 2. So imagine in this particular question, what happened? Out of four letters, one went into the correct envelope, and the other three, imagine, could be arranged in 2 times 1 times 1 way. So after one letter went into the correct envelope, the other three could be deranged in just 2 ways. So if you know that D3 is 2, you can just directly apply and save some time. D4 is 9, D5 similarly is 44, and frankly I have never seen a value greater than 5 in any question ever. So if you can just remember some of these, it may just end up saving some time. And now let's look at the last question on the last slide, this one. So this is simply D4, and as we saw in the last few seconds of this video, D4 is 9. So the answer for the last question here is 9, this particular value. And now let's solve a bunch of questions. Please pause the video and do it yourself. First question is the same. It's simply the value of D4, which is 9. The answer is 9 here. Look at the second question here. Only one goes into right envelope. So first select the right letter, 5C1, that is 5. And now the other four can be arranged, rather dearranged, in D4 ways. And therefore 5 into D4 is the answer. D4 is 9. So the answer is 5 times 9, 45. Look at the last question here. There are six. Two go into the right envelope. So out of six, two can be selected in 6C2, that is 15 ways. Okay. And the remaining four can be derranged in D4 ways. So the answer is 15 into D4. D4 is 9, we just saw. The answer is 15 times 9, 135. This was the concept, guys. GMAT shorts are deliberately kept brief. For an elaborate explanation, please refer the stage 1 videos. Thanks for watching.